Hello children, welcome to my class Atomic Structure Part 1. The topics we discuss in this session: Introduction, John Dalton Atomic Model, J.J. Thomson Atomic Model. We will discuss all these things one by one in detail. Children, you observe this clear stream of water, glass full of water, a wooden block, a wooden table, and so many things we use in our day-to-day life: the book, the paper, the water we drink, the food we eat, the air we breathe. These are all nothing but matter. So what is the scientific definition given for matter? Anything which has mass and occupies some space. Anything which has mass and occupies some space. So the entire universe is filled with matter. Okay. So what is the nature of the matter? To know the nature of the matter, to reveal the secret of matter, many scientists did several experiments. Let us discuss one by one in detail. The first scientist who studied the nature of the matter is John Dalton. Who is that? John Dalton. In the year 1808, he studied the nature of matter. He revealed the matter. So what is matter? Matter is made up of tiny particles. Tiny particles. How tiny they are? They are very small and cannot be seen with the naked eye. They are called atoms. Those tiny particles which cannot be seen with our naked eye, which cannot be further divisible, are known as atoms. So matter is made up of tiny particles known as the atoms. Next, another assumption: atoms only take part in chemical reactions to form the compounds. So atoms only take part in chemical reactions to form compounds. Next, atoms are the same element. How many atoms you consider of the same element, they are alike. They are alike. Atoms of the same element are alike, and atoms of different elements are different. These are the assumptions made by John Dalton. Okay, in the year 1808. So he studied the nature of the matter and revealed what is matter. He revealed that matter is made up of tiny particles. They cannot be seen with our naked eye, and they are not further divisible. But later several scientists did several experiments and proved that matter is made up of tiny particles known as the atoms, but those atoms are divisible. They conducted a series of experiments. Let us discuss those experiments in detail. See, what are the subatomic particles? What are the subatomic particles? See, as I told you, matter is not divisible as per John Dalton. Later, several scientists like J.J. Thomson, okay, after inventing discharge tube by William Crookes, J.J. Thomson and William Crookes conducted a series of experiments to prove Atom is divisible. So in the year 1879, William Crookes and J.J. Thomson discovered cathode rays using the discharge tube. Later, these cathode rays are named as electrons by G.J. Stoney. G.J. Stoney. In the year 1897, Goldstein discovered anode rays using the same discharge tube experiment. He named them as positive rays or anode rays or canal rays. They are also known as canal rays. Later, they are named as protons. In the year 1932, Chadwick discovered neutrons by bombarding beryllium atoms using alpha rays. So, in the Year 1879, William Crookes discovered, what is that? Discharge tube. Discharge tube. William Crookes and J.J. Thomson conducted a series of experiments to reveal the secret of atom. Secret of atom. And they proved that atom is further divisible, and atom consists of negatively charged particles known as the electrons and positively charged particles known as the protons. But neutrons were discovered several years later of the discovery of electrons and protons. These subatomic particles, what are they? Protons, electrons. These are the electrons and protons which are inside the atom are known as what we call them? Subatomic particles. What we call them? Subatomic particles. So, what are the subatomic particles? Subatomic particles are the particles which are present inside the atom. What are the subatomic particles? Electrons, and next one is the protons, the next one is the neutrons. Next one is the neutrons. These three particles, subatomic particles, are present inside the atom. So they are known as subatomic particles. Subatomic particles. Let us discuss in detail about the subatomic particles. As I told you, the subatomic particles are electrons, protons, and neutrons. These three are known as subatomic particles. Okay, electrons are negatively charged, and protons are positively charged, and neutrons are neutral. They are chargeless particles. They are chargeless particles. Next, the magnitude of the charge of the electron is -1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs. Here the charge of the positive particle, that is proton, is +1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs, and neutron is chargeless particle, so its magnitude is also zero. Next, relative charge, that is one unit. So electron is one unit and proton also one unit, but neutron is chargeless, it is zero. Next, mass of the electron is 9.10939 × 10⁻²⁸ grams, or 0.000548 amu. At the same time, mass of the proton is 1.672 × 10⁻²⁴ grams, or 1.007277 amu. Next, mass of the neutron is 1.675 × 10⁻²⁴ grams, or 1.00867 amu. If you observe these masses of protons and neutrons, they are almost equal. Observe this one, 1.672, here 1.675. okay, are you clear about that one? So we can say that mass of the proton is nearly equal to mass of the neutron. Next, whereas the mass of the electron is 1/1837 times of proton. Okay, next, we use the symbol -1 e⁻¹⁰ to denote electron, and to denote the proton, 11p or 1h1h we use as the symbol, and neutron is denoted by this symbol. Neutron is denoted by this symbol. Neutron is chargeless, but it has the mass which is equal to the mass of the proton. Next one, electron was discovered by J.J. Thomson. Actually, they are cathode rays. Negatively charged particles are named as cathode rays. J.J. Thomson discovered these negatively charged particles, but they are named as electrons by G.J. Stoney. Who is that? G.J. Stoney. Next, protons were discovered by Goldstein, whereas neutrons were discovered by Chadwick. Neutrons were discovered by Chadwick. In the year 1879, electrons were discovered. In the year 1897, protons were discovered. In the year 1932, neutrons were discovered. If you observe these years, neutrons were discovered so many years later after the discovery of electrons and protons. Electrons and protons. Okay. This is all about these charged particles, what is their charges and what is their masses. Are you clear? Now let us discuss how these subatomic particles, that is electrons, protons and neutrons, are arranged inside the atom is nothing but atomic structure. What do you mean by atomic structure? Atomic structure is the arrangement of subatomic particles. Subatomic particles. So the arrangement of subatomic particles inside the atom is called atomic model or atomic structure. Atomic model or atomic structure. Are you clear? So what do you mean by atomic structure? The arrangement of subatomic particles inside the atom is called atomic model or atomic structure. So the arrangement of protons, electrons and neutrons. Protons, electrons and neutrons. How they are arranged inside the atom is nothing but atomic structure. Okay. You will learn these protons and neutrons, they are present inside the nucleus. So they are known as nucleus. We will discuss in our next class. Let us discuss the first atomic model. The first atomic model proposed by Thomson. J.J. Thomson proposed the first atomic model in the year 1897. You observe this watermelon. This is a watermelon. So, J.J. Thomson proposed that, the atom is a sphere. The atom is a sphere which is completely filled with the positive charge, and the electrons are embedded just like the seeds in the watermelon in the reddish massive part. This is all he imagined, the entire reddish massive part as the positive charge, whereas these seeds, black seeds, as electrons. Are you clear? So this is also known as plum pudding model. What is that? Plum pudding model. Okay, so he compared his model to the watermelon. Okay, just like the seeds arranged inside the watermelon. Okay, the electrons are also embedded inside the positive charge of sphere. Okay, this is known as plum pudding model. Okay, let us discuss the salient features or postulates of Thomson atomic model proposed in the year 1897. What are the main postulates of Thomson atomic model? An atom consists of a positively charged sphere with negatively charged electrons embedded uniformly into the sphere. So, an atom consists of positively charged sphere with negatively charged electrons embedded uniformly into the sphere. Next, second one, the negative and positive charges are equal and opposite. Observe this one. The negative and positive charges are equal and opposite. So, the atom is electrically neutral. Okay, because of equality of positive charges and negative charges, the atom is electrically neutral. So, this model of atom is known as plum pudding model or raisin model. Okay, plum pudding model or raisin model. Okay, next, the main demerit is it failed to explain the result of gold foil scattering experiments carried out by Rutherford in the year 1911. So, this is the main drawback of Thomson atomic model. Okay, J.J. Thomson, the first atomic model proposed by J.J. Thomson in the year 1897 failed to explain the results of gold foil scattering experiment, okay, carried by Rutherford and many other scientists. Thank you, children. I hope I made the atomic structure part 1 crystal clear to you. If you have any doubt, please post your doubts to my channel. I will answer your doubts. At the same time, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And a link is provided in the description box. You click the link and play the quiz. Thank you.